This room represents the three races of Puerto Rico. There are the Taino Indians, which were the original inhabitants of Puerto Rico. They are still there. The African slaves that were brought to Puerto Rico, they are still Afro-Puerto Ricans. And the Spaniards that came to Puerto Rico. And all three cultures mixed and created what we have now, which is a diverse population of Puerto Rico.
Right here you have the Spanish, the Indian, and the African.
And here you have sugar cane, which is, this represents the sugar cane workers who used to toil in the fields when the Americans came to Puerto Rico. America still owns Puerto Rico. Puerto Ricans are American. America took over Puerto Rico. But when they came, they forced Puerto Ricans off their land and into the sugar cane fields. And a lot of them toiled and were forced to work for hours and without a break into the sugar cane field. And then they also took a lot of them and forced them onto planes and sent them straight into the fields without their knowledge. So they had no idea. They thought they were going to a new city like New York for a new life, but instead they ended up working straight into the fields. So this represents the people who didn't have a choice in what they did.
Right here is Atabe.
She is the highest goddess among the Taino Indians. She is the fertility goddess. And so she is one of the most recognizable symbols for most Puerto Ricans. In this room is also the religious aspect of Puerto Rico, and there's also a mask and other items as well. Okay, this is a Bay Gigante mask. They are worn during Carnival, and they are religious in nature. They are worn during the St. James festivals. These are santos that represents the patron saints that each town has in Puerto Rico.